let's talk about this drama, shall we?
Yeah. Girl, if you mad now, you should have seen what Lydia didn't put in.
Can everyone just leave Cece alone? We got in a stupid argument over something stupid. It's over now.
And are you excited? Because I sure am. Because it's already episode 4, and I still haven't gone home.
I am feeling good about my position in the cast. I would have been better if I had won a challenge.
I have decided that the winner of this week's challenge is Regan. Congratulations, Regan, on your first win. The bottom two this week will sadly be Sophia and Chai. I'm so sorry, but you will be lip-syncing.
I know something about love.
I've decided, Sophia, you have survived this lip-sync. Congratulations, you are on to next week. Chai, so sorry, that means you'll be eliminated.
Hi everybody, it's Sophia Von Hill, also known as Tyler, and I'm just making this video to like say that I am dropping out of Game of Drag, and I'm really sad about this, but I have to, you know, focus on my mental health and also on school, and that just means that I can't be investing as much time in drag as I have been. And I'm sorry. I love all my Game of Drag sisters. I'm really, really sad and heartbroken that I have to do this, but yeah. Bye.
Fucking Sophia dropped out. I'm super sad about that. Like, I love Sophia so much. She's like one of my favorite people. And she dropped, and it's really sad.
Hey, it's week 5. It seems like it's like week 10 or something. Last week was the bride one. That's what it was, the bride one. That was fun. Reagan won. That's good for her.
Hello everyone, it's me, Sick Summers. Because I'm fucking sick. And it's week 5 of Game of Friends. Or at least I thought it was Game of Friends until Cece wanted to say that I was gonna go home even though my look wasn't that fucking bad. I just watched the episode and I'm pissed. Cece said that she thought I was gonna go home this week. What? My look was definitely not that bad. I really don't even think I should have been in the bottom, but it's whatever. But I hype her ass up every week, telling her how great she is every week. Oh, Cece, you did so good. Oh my God. And then the first thing she has to say about me is Springs or Summer or whatever her name is going home this week. What?
Spring Summer has made a big deal about how I said I thought her look wasn't that good. And I thought that she might have been bottom too. Again, I love her. But, like, it wasn't a read at all. And it shouldn't have been taken that seriously. Like, I was just literally saying my opinion. Because I get, like, every time I say my opinion in these confessionals, like, it's so much fucking shit for no reason. Which I don't understand why. Because isn't this the point of our confessionals? Like, we're supposed to say, like, what we think.
Every, like, so often I'll get these messages, like, oh, well, your look was good this week. But, like, it's obvious that Trey and Berlin are gonna be the top. Like, Trey and Berlin is gonna be the top two. It doesn't matter what you do, because Trey's gonna win or Berlin's gonna win. And it's just like, Trey and Berlin's gonna win, so you don't even really have to try. Like, you're probably gonna end up going home. Like, Trey's gonna be the winner anyways. And it's just like, fucking, like, damn. Like, I'm still gonna try. Like, I'm still here. Like, it's week fucking 5 and I'm still here. I'm still kicking. I'm still being Springs. I just need to win. I need to win or get in the top or something.
Fight me.
So this week has been actually pretty calm in the chats as far as I know. I haven't really been in the chats. Girl, I haven't really been in the chats much this week because I've been dealing a lot with insurance and shit. I was in a car wreck, really bad one. So I've been kind of MIA for a while. And my phone broke, so I'm using a really shitty iPod Touch from like 6 years ago.
This week has been really dreadful for me, if I'm quite honest. I've had a few breakdowns and anxiety attacks because there's just a lot going on for me right now. Personally and physically and, you know, with all my drag stuff, it's just a lot. And so I'm not gonna make no excuses. There's no reason for that. I never stand for when other people make excuses, but it was just one of those weeks, okay? It's one of those weeks.
This week on GOD, I think that I did pretty good. We had to do a roast for Roachie, aka Roasties Roach. I'm so stupid. I pronounced it so wrong in the video. I don't care though, I think it's funny. But this week we had to do a roast on Roachie, and she said that we should incorporate other girls, and that's exactly what I did. I think I follow the rules every week. I do them to the T. I try to make it as good as possible. I try to follow exactly what she says. So I added in all types of jokes about the queens in the chat, but most of it was based around Roachie. And I'm proud of myself because of that. I think that I did really good. Shut up!
I'm kind of in a place right now where I honestly just don't care anymore about whether or not I like win or lose, because I don't think that anything I'm doing is really being received the way that I'm expecting it to be. So I'm just chilling and doing my own thing now. My priorities in terms of my self-worth in relation to winning this competition are changing. And I'm at peace with that, but I'm still gonna do really well because that's what I do, because I'm talented as fuck.
The one thing that I'm like not amazingly good at is the challenge, is this comedy challenge, and I'm nervous. I'm really scared about this. I don't even know how to feel. Like, whenever I think about it, like, my stomach kind of churns, and Nope. I'm, like, nervous because I don't want to... I don't know. The challenge is the roast, Roachie roast, and I don't know a lot about Roachie. If it was, like, the Lydia Collins roast, I feel like I'd kill that shit because, like, I can roast Lydia. Not that she's easy to roast, but I know more about her, if that makes any sense. Like, I have more material for her. Whereas Roachie's really... I feel like Roachie and I are friends. And I like Roachie a lot, but we're not, like, personal, so it's kind of hard, you know?
I just finished my stuff. And I'm not super duper proud of how it turned out, but I'm not a comedy queen. I'm just not. I like to sing, and I like to look beautiful. And I was challenged last week to step out of that box. So I went crazy this week, and I did something totally off-brand and off what is typically what I do. And I brought back my character, my fun alter ego, my friend from Jersey. I brought her back, Miss Goldie Gurr, so...
I'm excited, because I love roasting people. I'm actually a really shady bitch, and I have a lot of mean things that I don't say normally, that I'm excited that I actually get to say now. So, it's gonna be great.
I'm proud of myself, and I'm a little disappointed at the same time, because I don't think it was enough to be top in this race for now. But I think it was enough to be safe this week. And that's what I'm proud of. And if being safe takes me to the top, I'm fine with that. But I also do want to be in the top 31 week. That'd be amazing.
I was very nervous about this one because there's just a lot of material there to go after, I wasn't sure if I was just gonna seem like really mean or if my humor was actually gonna come across. Because a lot of times when I'm like reading people, it's so deadpan that you can't tell if I'm joking or not.
I don't think I came off bitchy. There was at least one or two reads in there that were just kind of like borderline bitchy. Like, I'm not here to make friends. I'm really here to win as much as I can, get as many of those highs and wins on my stat sheet as fucking possible. Berlin is either going to be really funny or extremely bitchy because I know that she doesn't necessarily like Roachie too much.
Her drag is just not my cup of tea in general. So I'm really worried that it's gonna be seeming like I'm like really mean, but I'm just trying to be funny and be, you know, do the challenge or whatever.
I hope you see that I did try on that stupid comedy challenge. I literally sat for like 3 days straight trying to think of something that was funny, but I'm just not funny. I'm funny like in conversation, but I can't think and write jokes. It's really not my forte, so so I'm just gonna hope for the best and hope that what I did end up doing is at least passable funny. And we'll just sort of have to go from there.
This week the challenge was to read Roachie, which y'all know how much I have a very strong opinion about her. So I'm glad I get to read her for once as a challenge. Because, I mean, I read her every day. It's my, it's a daily thing I do. But I'm happy that I can actually get, like, rewarded for doing it. It was a lot easier reading her than, like, other people, like we had to do last year. So I slayed that lip sync so hard. I love that song. I don't know what the song was for the lip sync, but the song is really iconic. It's my new favorite thing ever.
I had fun with the lip sync. This was the song that sent me home on Bratz Race when I was on Bratz Race. So it's like triggering, hashtag triggered. But no, it was fun. I just goofed off and I said, you know what, fuck it. If I'm in the bottom at least, and they sent me home, at least I had fun. Oh, I have to do the thing. Next scene. Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Hello everyone, and welcome to Game of Drag Season 2, Episode 5. This week, the girls were challenged to read Roachie in a Roachie roast. The runway was just to create a character in the roast and sell it. Let's see how they did.
I didn't see you there. Give me 1 second. This shit's bigger than Roachie's ego. Hi, I'm Reagan. Welcome to the first ever Roachie Roast. I'm gonna get this started by roasting a few of my not-so-lucky competitors. Let's begin. Let's start with our returning queen, Cece. Here in these past couple challenges, you've been looking really right. And also left. Berlin. Winning this competition against you is going to be a close shave. Not like you know anything about that.
It is time for me to introduce the winner of Game of Drag Season 1, Candice Chick. I said winner, not rightful winner. Let me introduce Roachie. Now Roachie, I hear you're one of the smartest people in the community right now. Too bad you're letting me go to waste. I don't know a lot about you, Roachie, but I know you won Game of Drag Season 1, and you're famous for your iconic Roachie the Riddler. And not to mention your endless creativity and originality, as you can see from your blue face mask top 3 look.
God.
Now, some of your Season 1 sisters have informed me that you send in a winning confessional every week. Now, if that doesn't scream egotistical, I don't know what does. Lydia. Out of all the amazing, talented, wonderful girls in Season 1, you really had to pick the runt and the litter to win, didn't you? Nature's a cruel bitch. Speaking of Lydia, I love every single post on your page. Literally, you're amazing. That one look you have is my favorite. Roachie, I really, really love how your aesthetic is just orange hair. I'm really inspired by the fact that you're inspired by Carrot Top. It is my honor to introduce the queen herself, Bacteria.
Oh my god, the Ziploc bag! Nobody's gonna know what that means.
Roasty's Roach. Who the fuck is that? Oh, now I remember. I guess we have to roast her. Bye. Ugh. Smells like burnt turtle dick. Ugh. No wonder I forgot who Roachie was. Her personality is plainer than Chai's looks and Cece's makeup. Wait, take that back. Cece's boomerang eyebrows were pretty cool and creative. Oh my god, guys. Speaking of Roachie, she just posted a new Instagram video. She looks so good. Oh my god, her lip sync skills have gotten so good. I'm shooketh. Roachie has really stepped it up, but I still hate that bitch. I don't see why Roachie won season one of GOD. I mean, like, I saw her eating Lydia's ass a few times. Maybe that's how she won. But that's, like, rigged. Team Candace Cherry. Now I know why they call roaches cockroaches. I mean, she was eating actual shit out of Lydia's ass. Dirty booty ass. I've always wondered how Roachie was conceived. She's a roach, but yet she's like a human. I always thought that call from Jimmy Neutron fucked a roach and then she was born. That's actually fucking gross. In all seriousness, I love Roachie. She never fucking likes my looks. Ever. She fucking hates them. I mean, but I love her. This has been Roachie's Roast. Now I'm going to call a fucking fire department to put that dumb bitch out. 911, what's your emergency? Okay. Next up is Trey. Please, bitch, go home for all of us. Love you.
Hey y'all, it's the girl, Goldie Girl, your favorite non-Joycey Joycey girl. They always say, you can take the goyle out of Joycey, but you can't take the leopard print out of the goyle, am I right? Now Trey couldn't be here this week because he's too busy. So we had a good old girl, Goldie Girl from Joycey, come and help him out.
Oh god.
Now Lydia, it is so nice of you to let us read these goyles. Now speaking of reading, I talked to your mom. You need to work on your fourth grade reading homework tonight, okay? Stop editing the video and work on your reading homework, okay? Love you, girl. Now, the woman of the hour, Miss Roachie. Girl, your hair is so orange, you look like Ronald McDonald, okay?
Very fitting read.
I think you need a Big Mac so you can work on those womanly curves, okay? Girl, your hair is so red, you look like the little orphan Annie. But it didn't look like the sun came out for you tomorrow. Now that little 7-year-old got herself a Daddy Warbucks. Why can't you get yourself a daddy to help you, you know, spice up that tired look of yours? Girl, your hair is so red, you be looking like Carrot Top, you know, the comedian, but at least she's funny and successful. Last week, girl, you was doing the dishes, right? Well, those dishes were just about as crusty as that makeup. And trust me, girl, I know about makeup. And the week before that, you was wearing that white mask, looking like the chainsaw masker guy. You should pull a Valentina and keep it on, girl. Save us all some trouble for looking at that mug of yours. Now, Roachie. here is some advice from your girl, Goldie Girl, okay? Get your nails did. Get your hair did. Get some dick and everything will be okay. Okay? Love you, girl. Now, on to my girl, Quasimodo. I mean, Cece. Goldie Girl is out.
Quasimodo is accurate.
To exterminate this bitch.
The door.
Roachie, you won the Death by Drag challenge on the first season, which is surprising because no one was living in the first place. Roachie, you think with an extra arm on your back that you would actually have better luck tucking? Obviously not. Roachie, Target saw your finale look, and they're hoping you have a bad aim.
Uh-huh.
Anita couldn't help me come up with reads because she was eating. I wouldn't blame her. I wouldn't want to look at Roachie while I was eating either. You know what I hate more than roaches? Bedbugs. Which is why I would never put one of Bacteria's bedsheet creations on my body. Summer, I mean Springs? Whatever the hell your name is. You're the most iconic filler queen this season. But instead of filling a spot, maybe you should try filling your wig with some conditioner, because your shake and go is looking more dry than Roachie's mangina.
Thank you for being here today, Mr. Roachie. I appreciate you being punctual, I really do. Now, I will cut to the chase. The reason you are here at Clark and Clark Law Firm is because you are being sued. This is a cease and desist order from the entire roach population. Now, basically, they don't want you to use their name anymore because they do not want to be associated with you. And honey, can you really blame them? I mean, look at yourself. Really, take a good, hard look at yourself. God damn. Anyway, they've given me a list of, I guess you would call them complaints or basically justifications for why they are filing this suit against you. And I will read those out to you because they didn't want those communicated. So here's what they had to say. Roachie, you look like the fucked up love child of Carrot Top and a skid mark. Roachie, your contour is muddier than the Gulf Coast after Hurricane Harvey. Oh, that's a low blow. Those families are really hurting. Roachie, your blending is dirtier than the teen queen Bacteria. And you know what? She once used a sandwich bag as a condom. She's a dirty one. You know what? That's on record. That's a fact as well. The roaches would also like, this is a separate thing, but they would like to file for emotional distress because when they look at your eyebrow cover, it reminds them of the crunching noise that you hear when someone steps on a roach, and that just is really triggering for them. It's just, it's so crunchy. They do find that distressing. But I'll get back to their complaints. This one is creative. They said, Roachie, the sexual tension between your eyebrows, it's too much for them. You know, they want the eyebrows to just be able to kiss already and get it over with. But I guess it is that long nose contour that goes all the way up to the top of your wig trying to snatch it forward that keeps them apart. I mean, honey, you know you're just making that big bell pepper look even bigger. Alright, they didn't really have anything else to say, but you know what? I really do want to commend you because there's not a lot of people who've been doing drag for over a year and still look like that, but still have so much confidence in themselves. It's really honestly very baffling. I don't understand it, but it is very inspiring that you still feel like you should be doing this. I think it's amazing, and you should keep hoping and keep trying. Also, you might be called back into the office because there is possibly going to be another cease and desist order against you from Target. They say that you're depleting their plastic bag resources and they're losing profits because of it. That's pretty much all I have today. This meeting has already gone on a lot longer than you take to do your makeup, so I think we're gonna end it here. Have a good day, sir!
That was so good.
Oh, sorry, I didn't see you there. I was cooking a roast. My name is Spring Summers, also known as Springs, Slut, Summer, Sprigs, and Autumn Winters. Or, you might know me from not winning any challenges on Game of Drag. I know that I'm probably going to get complaints about this look, because I've worn it so many times. But the challenge wasn't to come up with a look, it was to make Roachie want to slit her wrists. I'm going to start out by roasting some of my sisters. Bacteria. Germex might only be able to wipe away 99% of you, but Lydia can wipe you away 100%. CC Vitality. I mean sweetheart. Good thing you changed your name because you realized that you weren't vital to this competition. Trey. Before I came out, I had a beard too, but I got rid of it. You should too. Reagan, the only thing that pops up when I search your name is Ronald Reagan, and that should offend you enough. Kiss Me, I honestly forgot you were even here, so I didn't really write down anything for you, sorry. Berlin, I don't have anything to say about you, so love your hair, hope you win. And now it's time for our guest of honor, Roachie. You might know her from winning Game of Drag, or from talking shit about all of the season 2 contestants to our faces. Roachie. What does the guy you recently asked out in Drag Showdown have in common? They both turned you down.
That one hit close to home.
Roachie, your housewife look is wrong in so many ways. Not because you stole the mug from somebody, but because no one's ever going to want to marry you. Roachie, it's funny that you clean up and all of your critiques, but you can't clean up that makeup. Roachie, the only thing smaller than my chances of winning this competition is the space in between your eyebrows. Roachie, I don't know why you're wasting your time stacking all those wigs. We can still tell that you're a man. Roachie, I think it's ironic that you're holding a plunger in one of your pictures because your head is really plunged into Lydia's ass. To complete this roast, I would just like to say that you really deserve to win Game of Drag. And congratulations. I can't wait to hear more critiques from you.
Oh, you ended it so nice. I was not expecting it to end like that. I was expecting it, like, just kidding, bitch.
Before we kick this roast off, I have a few things to say for the rest of the cast. Spring Summers. You know, spring is so fucking high all the time, and I swear to God, this bitch is always eating. In the group chat, like, the first thing that she does every single day in the group chat is, hey guys, it's looking a lot. This hungry hoe, the first thing that she said when she found out we were doing a roast, she was like, oh my God, I love ham. And I was like, no, wrong. You know, Spring Summers, your name is so ironic because you're not hot and you're not fresh. Actually, if anything, you remind me of those bags of donuts that donut stores throw away at the end of the night. Because, one, here's the list. You're usually stale, kind of crusty, and hard. And usually, only the desperate will dive in that dumpster to eat that up. Reagan. Out of drag, why the fuck do you look so much like the kid from 2.5 Men? Berlin. Now, Berlin is super talented, but what many of you guys don't know is she has another amazing talent. Now, since I met her, I have basically begged to God that she would miraculously show up in Texas and live in my car. She is so fucking good at making excuses that she would be able to get me out of a ticket like that. Berlin's got more excuses than a dentist office. Trey, watching you do drag is like playing dress up with a Bratz doll. The makeup is always the same, the outfits are slightly different and kind of interesting. Growing up, I used to collect them. I was obsessed with them. I loved them so much. I loved the outfits. I loved how they looked. But eventually, they all the looks started looking the same, and I grew out of it. Trey, I'm gonna keep you short and simple. And it's not really a roast, but out of drag, why the fuck do you look so much like David Blaine? Bacteria. No, I can't roast bacteria. I love her too much. Cece. Since Lydia didn't put this in the last one, I'll put it in this one. Your eyebrows are shaped like an Australian boomerang. Every single fucking time you draw them on. I will insert a picture now. Cece, when you talk, I don't really know how to describe it, but you always have this like thing where you just like don't really know what the fuck is going on, and you use your hands a lot like this. I don't really know what that's about, but it's really fucking weird.
This is so real.
And now, the moment we've all been waiting for. Let's get this roast started. Roachie. To start things off with Roachie, I want to talk about how amazing her makeup is. I have never in my life seen someone that was able to accomplish a nose contour that reminded me so much of Moses parting the Red Sea. The great thing about Roachie is Roachie's makeup, it's a true talent. It's not easy to achieve the look of a cross-eyed Chinese schoolgirl doing your makeup. Roachie won Game of Drag season 1. And you know how I know Roachie is talented is because she won Game of Drag season 1 without once attempting to tuck or shave. Her makeup was flawless, her costumes were flawless. I have never in my life been so attracted to someone walking around looking like a Wookiee everywhere, but here up. It was phenomenal.
The Wookiee. Well, let's see. Now I talk. And
welcome back, everybody. Now, let's move on to critiques. This week, everyone will be getting critiqued. Let's start with Berlin Fatal. So Berlin, your roast this week was the most put together to me. You stayed in character the entire time, you didn't break once. You sat there for 3 minutes delivering great reads and jabs at Roachie. And your last few reads were the ones that really tipped it right over the edge for me with your 3 minute mug read. I don't have much to complain about this week. Good job.
Berlin, you put on a character that I haven't seen before and that really worked. You kind of used a trope that made things funny, and it was almost like you yourself weren't reading me, but you were like telling me what other people said, in this case roaches and Target, and it was so funny. I was laughing. Your entire performance, I was laughing and smiling the whole time. I don't think my eyebrows are crusty when I cover them, but great job this week.
Next up, we have bacteria. So bacteria, your roast started out strong with burning a dead cockroach, and I, for some reason, was cracking up at you holding the phone, saying, look how good Roachie got, and it's this video of, like, I don't even know what it is, but it was funny to me. In the middle, your reads kind of got a little confused. It looked like you didn't really know what you wanted to say, and I think you could have had a notepad in front of you, like, guiding you through it, saying, alright, up next is this joke, and I have to land this next, but sometimes they just didn't land how you would have liked them to.
Bacteria, to me, it felt like you didn't, like, rehearse enough, if that makes sense. Like, I didn't really need this to be 100% memorized or, like, a complete movie script or whatever, but it seemed like you wrote them down, you started filming, and you did one take. There were a lot of, like, verbal slip-ups, I think, and it seemed very choppy going through the whole thing. And I don't know, I didn't laugh too much. I laughed a little bit. I didn't laugh too much.
Next up, we have Spring Summers. Spring, I am so proud of you this week. Your look isn't fully realized with what you were reading Roachie on, but your reads were some of the best this week. The only problem I have with it is that some were a little bit repetitive when you kept saying their names, but it adds to that kind of dry humor, which I really liked. I thought you had some good personal jabs at Roachie, and it all just worked together with the editing and the fuck Roachie. That was really good. I'm proud of you this week.
Spring, even though your look was busted, I had never seen it before, so I guess you haven't been posting it enough or whatever. I think you did a really great job this week as well, reading me, but also your other competitors. I was laughing. Some of them were a little bit of a miss for me, but otherwise I was laughing most of the time. And nice job this week. I know that you didn't really have time to get into real drag, but it still worked out for you.
Regan Nore, your roast was actually really funny this week. I know you were worried going into this week, but I think you having two looks on top of the good reads you delivered benefited you this week. I really liked the shadiness you had towards me and Roachie. I think you could have spat out the jokes a little bit faster if you wanted to be ultra effective like some of the other girls this week, but overall it was one of my favorites. You've been delivering us something different and unique each week, and I think girls need to keep an eye on you. Trey, last week we asked you to deliver us something that we haven't seen before from you, something different, and this is definitely something different. I've seen you do this character before on another race. I'm not sure if I like it better this time or last time. Last time, the makeup was bad with a purpose. But this time, I think it's just gotten a little, bad. That's definitely your character, and that's fine. So I'm not mad at that, because you did have jokes to back it up. The first time I watched it, I wasn't really too into the roast, but then the next time I watched it, I did like the character a little bit more.
The look was a little off-putting. I understand sort of what you were going through, but it's still very weird to look at. The accent was also weird as well. While I understand it's a Jersey girl, I feel like Jersey girls can still pronounce their R's. Some of the stuff hit, some of it missed, most of it missed. Again, I don't really remember your performance too much.
Kizmi, your roast covered a lot of things. Some of them didn't make sense, others did make sense. But I'm just so impressed with your dedication to this race, with everything that has been going on with you in this past week. You turned out something that most girls couldn't turn out on a regular week. I'm so proud of you this week for actually submitting something and making it not terrible.
Kismi, I commend you for having gone through so much recently and still being able to turn out this challenge. I was laughing a lot. Some things didn't really land, but still worked. The only thing that I didn't really like was that it took 4 minutes and 43 seconds from start to finish. But otherwise, I was laughing a lot. Especially that you did insert a picture of a boomerang to represent Cece's eyebrows. So, nice job.
Next up is Cece. Cece, your reads went in and you really showed that you have what it takes to make a good roast. But I think reading them off of your iPad was an extremely bad move. I couldn't see your face half the time. Your eyes were always darting back and forth from the camera to the iPad. You had some of the best reads this week, but they were not delivered well at all, and that broke the entire cycle of your good roast.
I don't know how, like, what to say for this. It was just a bit of a miss for me this week. You looked great. Some of the stuff hit, but I don't know. I don't know. I don't really know what else to say. It was not very memorable for me.
All right. When I call your name, it means that you are safe and moving on to next week. Trey, Kismi, you two are safe this week.
And for the bottom two this week, I will be assigning you to the bottom two without consulting Lydia. The first person to be in the bottom two this week is Bacteria. The second person to be in the bottom two this week is Cece. I'm sorry, but you are both up for elimination.
Berlin, Spring, and Reagan, you are the top three of the week. Congratulations. After some deliberation with Roachie, as always, I've decided that the winner of this week's challenge... The winners of this week's challenge are Berlin and Spring. Congratulations, you two. Reagan, that means you are safe this week.
due to having another contestant drop this week due to personal conflicts, you will both remain in the competition. Congratulations. We'll see you next week.
Join us next time on Game of Drag.